So, hello everyone. I am Grandmaster Sébastien Mazet from France, and I will do a lecture about the Rouken Games and the famous, or not so famous. Okay, moment, just yes, about the role of Cheron. It was a French player who invented this idea. Like 100 years ago, and it will be about Rook and games and this rules we can call like 5-6. I will explain. It's in endgames when you have rook and pawn against rook and when the king is cut. So for example here, the king is cut from this pawn because the rook is controlling the e5, so the king cannot go here. So this rule 5-6 is about to count how far is the pawn. So for example, the pawn here is on the fourth, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, and is cut by two columns, so 1, 2. So we count like this. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4 plus 1, 2. So it's 6. The idea is when it's 6 or more, it's winning, and when it's less, it's draw. It's a rule who can help you in many endgames to know if you can make a draw, or if you can, or if you are losing or winning by counting very quickly. So in this example, as you can see, we are in a setup with 6. So I can do it again. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4. You count from the first square of the board, and you have these two columns. So you have 6. The idea is now you can progress with your king. For example, king d4. If you give check, I go with the king. And the idea is now my pawn can just go and there is no more check. So this is the first idea of this rule. I will show like many examples to explain you some exception to see some tricks and some idea to survive in some position. So this is a very specific subject of chess in endgame. So of course it's not often to reach this position, but you can have it sometimes. Okay, so here we have 4 plus 2, so 6. So here, okay, save. Second one, in this position, we have this position with 1, 2, 3. So the pawn is on the third rung, so it's 3. And the king is cut by two columns, 1 and 2. So it's 5. So when it's 5, it's draw. If we do the same as the previous example, king d3, rook d8, the king is going, and the idea is now we can just attack the rook. The rook cannot go in this on the e5 because the pawn is hanging, so the rook is going on d3. King e4, we attack again the rook, this and check. And rook d3, and it's just a draw. So this is the difference between two, that when the pawn is too far, the king cannot attack the rook quickly, and now the black have a defense by attacking the rook, and white cannot find a plan to win this position. So it's very important to count well. So if you have this position, just 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, so you have 5, now it's a draw. It's a rule who is not famous at all, and I think it's very important to know it. It will help you a lot in end games when you have not a lot of time at your clock. In this position? This one? Mm. Or the previous one? Ah, previous?
This position.
Yes? This is not winning. It's tablas. Because you cannot advance your king because there is too many checks. The pawn is on 3, so it's too far. And the idea is just to, for example, if I show you the difference. You want to go with the king?
King d6 and rook d2.
Rook d8?
No, king f4.
King f4, yes. Rook d3. Rook e4.
No, rook d8.
Ah, rook d8, yeah. Okay, yes, of course. Sorry. Of course, it's winning for black, but okay, it was just the example. Of course, it's rook h3. Sorry. Exactly. It was a mistake by me. Okay, so... well done. It's winning for black, yes, sometimes. Okay, so next one. In this position, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and the king is cut by one column. So it's 5. Okay? So 5, when it's 5, it's a draw. Okay? Because as we see, if the king is going, king b4. We just attack the rook. This is important for black to have the king well placed in the 6 or 5 ranks to attack this rook. Because now you attack the rook, if you just give a check, I go. And if you want to progress with the king, I just give some check. And here, you cannot go here because you lose the pawn. And if you go, you try to escape via a6, same, I go like this. And if you go c5, your rook is hanging. So you cannot. And you have to go back, king d4, and now king e5 attacking the rook. The rook has to move, and the king is going back to save the position. So here we have 5, and this is the example. For example, a classical mistake now is to give a check. But the difference now is the rook is on d4, is protecting the pawn. So it means now my king is free to go. For example, like this. And if you cannot take the pawn because it's attacking. And if you go just like this, I just go king c7, and now I will push the pawn. So it's important to attack this rook with protecting the pawn. And when the rook is moving from this fourth file, you can just give many checks as you want because the king cannot go. So, okay, so it means that the position of the black king in defense is very important. So to survive, you need to have less column as possible, and when you have 5, as we see here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and one column, 5, you need to put your king close to the rook. For example, in this position it's the same, but the king, as you see, is far away. So now king b4, and the king cannot go to e5. because the king is on e7. So king e6, now just c5, I push the pawn, and as you can see, it's now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one column, so 6. So now it's just winning very easily. Just the rook is moving, and I don't know, like you go with the king, and there is no check, and you just progress with your pawn, and you go to promote. So here it will be a simple win, because the black king is far away. So in defense, I will say it a lot, but it's very important that your king is close to the rook. So here some exception when it's 6 and it could be a draw. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. The pawn is on the first rank, and you have 1 and 2 columns with the king is cut from the b pawn. So it's 6. Okay. If it's white to move, it's a simple win because I go king c4, as I told you, and now I want to go b5 and to push the pawn. If you go check, you just move the king and you go here, and the move works, and you go b5 and you go to promote. So okay for this. Yes, and now the example with black to move. This is now 5 and exception point B. So here, okay, so you have the position on 6, but it's B pawn. B pawn, this is the only case when you have a draw, B or G, because now after king E5, you attack the rook. And if the rook move, you can just move your king. And now, after rook a4, you just give check, king b5, rook b8, king c5, check. And of course, if king b6, you give this check, and king c7. Now the rook is not on d4, so just rook take b4. And it's a draw. So, this is the exception with this b pawn. The difference between b pawn and, for example, c pawn. In this position, so here is the same position compared to the previous one. The only difference is the B and C pawn. The difference is now after king E5. So yes, I will count again. Here we have this classical 1, 2, 3, 4 and two columns who separate the king to the pawn. So 6. So 6 should be winning. And it's a C pawn. So here we can see the difference is the king now is going, he has one more file here compared to the b pawn. And if rook a5, rook c8, king b5, I want to push my pawn, so black has to give a check, king a6, because when you don't have these columns in the previous example, you have to go king c6, and now you have check. And of course, if you go here, you lose the pawn and you have to come back and it's draw. But in this example, we have this, we can go on the A file. This is the main difference. Of course, if rook A8, you go king B7, you want now to push the pawn. If king A5, you go king B6, rook A8, you go C5, and now you will win easily. And if the rook is attacking the pawn, rook C8, the difference, now you have to play rook c1 to protect, king e7, king b6, you want to push, king d7, black wants to come back with the king to make a draw, rook d1, king e8, and now you push. And it's a simple win. I will just show you here, you will understand easily the difference here. For example, king e5, rook d1, king e6, and in this position, for example, tac, 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 it's winning if, for example, I have this square over the board on the left, but I cannot go. I have no file open, so I cannot go on this file. So it's why this B pawn is draw.
Does it mean that for B pawn you need 7 instead of 6?
Yes. Ah, it's a good question. For B pawn you need 7 instead of 6. Yes, because if you have 7, it will be winning. Yeah. We can. I think I will show an example just after. So for example, this position, black king is far away. Okay, so in this example, what do we have? We have, what's the score of the, it's 5 or 6 here. Here it's 5. You have the pawn on the second square, so it's 1, 2. And the black king is cut 1 file, 2 file, 3 file. So it's 5. White and as an idea is to try to go to 6. Because as we know, if you reach 6, it's winning. How you can reach 6? The idea is, for example, if black is playing a random move like king g7, we go rook e3.
And
king
f1, is it winning?
Yeah, rook f1, you go, you will go to 7, yeah, of course. It's winning, you go to 6, yeah. Okay, I will go like rook f6, sorry, king f6. Rook e3. The idea of white is to go to b3. If you go to b3, it means that you will go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you will reach 6, and it's winning. So black has to attack this rook. As I told you, it's very important that the king can attack this rook. For example, if b3, now you go king f4, and white has to cannot stay here because you lose the pawn. And if they go here, you come back with the king, and now you will go to 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, so it's 3 plus 2, 5, and it's a draw. I will show you with the passage like here. So here, it's white to move, the same position with white to move, rook e3, king f6, b3, king f5, king b2. So now, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, so 3 plus 3, 6, king f4, now I can move my rook because my pawn is protected. In this position, I will show you also how to win this position. For example, if black is waiting, we know that he's winning, but now you know, you have to know how to do it. Not so easy. Later, I will show you, sorry, I will show you a game where I was black and my opponent didn't know this rule and didn't manage to win. Not so easy, but you have to know it. So king f5, of course if you go with the king, the problem is you will face many checks. You go check, 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 and if you don't know how to do it, sadly it will be a draw. But here, you have a correct move to win, is now you can go rook b1. Because the black king cannot come back. If king f5, I go b4, and the king cannot go back, and nothing to do. If check, king b7, and the pawn will push to reach the promotion. Yes, so for example, in this position that I play here, I played this game last year. It was a bad game for me. I was completely lost. For example, this endgame, I have 2 pawn downs. Position is completely lost. I will resign soon, but I try to play some moves. I play some moves. My player is exchanging. He's giving me a pawn back. Even like this, he's still in the game. And now we reach something interesting. For example, here. Here, because I know this rule, we have the count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7, it means it's completely winning. So when I play this position, I know it's completely winning. My opponent didn't know that it's completely winning. He played king c5, he tried to hide his king, and I come back. As we see before, the only plan to win is to go like this and this. So for example here, for example, rook b1, rook f1, sorry, king g5, king c3, check, king d4, check, king c5, check, you go with the king here, you go here to attack, and you go rook b1. If you go rook b4, king c5, rook b8, and now you just push. If the king comes back, you just go like this, and even like this, now you can cut, and you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the king is cut by 2, so it's 7. Completely winning. Now the pawn will just go to promote very easily with the king too far away, too close to the 8th rank. So my opponent in this position decide to go for rook f4. Rook f4 is a weird move. Without ID, I go rook g5 and he go rook c4. King f5, b4, king e5, king b3, king d5. And what do we have now? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 1, 5 is cut. So now my opponent was quite happy to push this pawn, but the problem now, the position is completely draw because we reach 5 and he cannot progress. As we can see, he play rook c1, I play king d6. Now, of course, the king cannot go because I give many checks as possible. And he cannot hide of king b6, rook b8, so this is not possible. So he went rook c5, rook e8, rook here. I just move my queen. Of course, if I go rook b8, this is a big mistake because now he play b5. And now we have this position, or he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and one file, so it's 6, so it's winning.
Even if it's b-pawn?
Ah, it's b-pawn, it when was... yeah, it's a good question. I will explain you. B-pawn is when... the example I show you, it's when it was 6. It could be draw when it was 6. When it's b pawn. So if it's 5, you mean, yeah, okay, sorry, I didn't understand in the right way.
In this case, it's 6, but
yeah, it's not the same 6. So okay. It's a 6 with a pawn on the 4th rank. So it was 6 example.
Yeah, this time the pawn is more advanced.
Yes, so here you have this 6, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 6, but the pawn is on b4. So it means that the king cannot go because you have this check. In the other position, it's on the left here. In this position, rook b8, b5. Now it's 6, but with other setup and pawn on fifth. When the pawn is on fifth, there is no chance to survive. Because for example, just here, rooks, or here you have b6, so you cannot move the rook. I mean, king d7, just Rook c6, king b6 after. I will just show you on an example. I will put I will explain you like this. So pawn, king, and rook. Okay. For example, white to move. Okay, I have to put the king. Okay, whatever. Okay, just to explain you when the pawn is on 4 or 5. If the pawn is on 4, if black is giving check, king, you cannot hide your king because you have this check, and if you go king c6, you lose the pawn. If you go king c7, you lose the pawn. If the pawn is on 5, on the fifth rank, sorry, new position setup, okay. What is the difference is now when you give check, king b6, check, now you go king c6, and if you give check, you go here. You are too close to the rook. So this rule is very important, this rule 5-6, when it's the pawn is on the 4th, 3rd or 2nd rank. When it's on the 5th rank, I mean you are by force you are 6, because the king, the black king is cut, so it's 5 plus 1, so it's 6, and there is no chance to survive. So it was a good question. It's important to understand that all this idea is working with the first rank minimum. Enfin, I mean, you cannot go on the fifth. So, yeah, in this position, rook c4 is a terrible mistake because now my king is coming. For example, if black is playing king f6, how can you win this position with white? Yeah, rook e4, exactly. Rook e4, because you make a mistake by going back here, so it's a terrible mistake. If, okay, you want to go with the king quickly here, you go king f6, you can avoid your previous mistake by coming back, and if he attack, now you come back here. And still, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's why I was saying I was completely lost, because here I have 7. So even if my opponent is playing badly, he can still save his mistake. So rook c4 is why king f5 is very important. Because now I control this square. And if he go b4, I just come back as you see in the game. And now I reach 5. If he go, for example, rook c5, I go here, b4, king d6, and he cannot go b5 to reach 6.
When you move b4, you lose the pawn.
Yeah, okay, sorry. I mean, he cannot reach this ID to go with the pawn. Yeah, he cannot go b4, of course. He has to go king c3, you go king d6, and b4, now you have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 5, so it's 5, so it's a draw. Also, one thing which is quite important, it's, how can I show you this? It's working only when the king is on the good, for example, like this. Rook f4, I mean king g5, like say rook c5, rook f5, check, take, this. Here we have a setup where we have 1, 2, 3, and the king is cut by 2, so it's 5. But the king, this king is in the bad area, so it means he cannot go back and he's completely cut, as you can see, by the rook, so he cannot move, and white now will just push easily his pawn to b5 and now to go with the rook. For example, I don't know, rook here. I just go rook c4. No move for black. And I just push. And simply, I progress with my pawn and my rook and my king. And then after my pawn and my rook. So the defense, for the defender, you need to go with the king in the good way. So in the direction of your rook. Okay, so here it's this. So it was important to see that in this position, if you know this rule, immediately you know that you can win this position by counting well. Okay, this another setup. So this one we did it. This one. Okay, I will put a new position. So for example, black is white is like this. Black is like this. King, pawn, and rook. Okay. So we have this position. White to move. No, it's not this position. What do I do? Something like this. Yes. Okay. White to move. So this is an example of a game that was shown in the book of Dvoretsky, the king of endgames. We explain very well also this rule. In this position, white is in trouble. Black wants to go to queen. The king is far away. And this rook also is far away. Do you have an idea how to play with white in this position? If you go king b, rook b6, I'm happy because my idea is just to go with the king and then to then to push. Okay. Yes.
King
d3. It's interesting because you want to attack the rook. If I go rook e1, what we want to reach is what we worked on it. So
rook,
what?
Rook
here? H8? I just go with the king, king g5.
Rook
f8? Here? Yes, but the problem now is I will push my pawn step by step, and what we want, it's you will not manage to do the rule 5-6 because here you have two 5 cut. So the pawn is on 3, so it's already 5, and my pawn is going. So it means your rook is not well placed.
G8.
Now?
No.
King d3? King d3,
in this yes.
Rook e1,
in this position, rook h8,
rook h8, king here,
and rook g8.
Yeah, rook g8. The problem is now the king is just moving, for example, king f5. with the idea to go g5. If you go check, I go like this. This is a classical way to progress. In French, we say in escalier. In English, how we say in English? I don't know. Step up like this, step by step. And here, this, if you go like this, I go king g3, you go like this, etc. So, what we want with white?
Another possibility, change of side the rook until b1 to kind of stop the pawn in g1.
Yeah, this is exactly what we want to do. You have to reach this rule 5-6. So how can we reach? This is very important. The only way to have the rule 5-6 is when your rook is in front of the pawn, not behind the pawn, in front. Because when she is behind, you stop nothing. The king can just go like this and you can do nothing. When the rook is here, you stop everything, because when the pawn is pushing, you give check, the king is hiding, you come back. And not possible to progress. So here, why king d3 is not good? Because look at this, king e1, king d2, you attack the rook, rook e5, rook b1, g5, I want to go g4 now, you go rook g1, I go king h5, I want to go g4. Here we have we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but it's b pawn or g pawn. But what we say before, it's very important where the king is. If you remember well, when I put this position, I say if it's white to play, it's winning because the king is not well placed. And if it's black, you play king e5 and you attack the rook. So you cannot go with your king because there is rook here. Here you come back. There is no way to progress.
No, if king g4 before.
I just wanted to show. Here, what is the problem for white? Is this king? Because you give check, I go back. You go here, king f5, and this king is far away. No, he's not in d4, he's in d2. So I can just go with my king because my pawn is protected, and I will just go with the pawn. So in this position, rook d3 is bad. Rook d3 is bad because the black rook is going on e1. You cannot reach the first rank because of this rook. So you have to play king d2. The king now is far away, rook e5, and now it's not good. So here, how to play for white?
Rook
b1, exactly. Rook b1 with a weird move, because of course, by instinct, we want to come back with the king quickly as possible. We say, okay, if we go with the king, it's Joe. But rook g1, sorry, rook g1, rook b1, sorry. For example, g5.
King
d3. King d3, yes. Rook e5. Now you just give a check. This, king here. Oh no, sorry, not here. King d4, you attack the rook, and there is nothing to do for black because it's a b pawn, and even it's 6, the king cannot go hide like this. So you cannot survive in this position. So what is important to know, and it's very important this role, because sometimes even in blitz, you can count this in 1 second and it will help you in any situation. Of course, there is some exception, but it's even some grandmaster many times that don't know this rule because it's not famous at all and is not so easy. I don't know why few people know it, but If you know it, it will help you to win or to draw some lost position. As you can see in my previous game, I drew a completely lost endgame, even it was 7. Another.
Excuse me?
Yes.
You said that it's a mistake to go
rook b1? Rook
b1? No, after that, like it was almost the last move.
Ah, sorry. Ah, oui, yes.
It's a mistake. In your game, you said also that it was a mistake to put the rook again in front of the pawn.
Ah, yeah, here, rook g1. To. I say rook g1, it's. No, the idea is for white it's very easy. You give check when you can give check, and then you have to protect this. So you have to go rook g1 here, but even here it's too late. Because king f5. In my game, I think I know what you mean. Yeah, sorry, because it's very tricky to to make some mistake, because sometimes you have to be precise. I think I say it here. So okay, so this is the position. He blunder. Tac. Roxy. Ah.
Yeah.
Ah shit. Sorry, it's going too quickly. I cannot do anything. So. Rook c5, yes. Rook c5, it's very easy. White wants to go king c4. So rook e8, you can move your king. This, and now I say rook g1 is a mistake. Enfin, rook rook b8.
Yeah.
And you want to know why rook b8 is a mistake?
Yeah.
Yeah, because rook b8 is a mistake because you play rook b8 when you want to avoid the push. Or here you avoid nothing because he push as you want. So here you have to move rook h8. If b5, of course, now you win the game. So when you are in defense, you play this move when you want to avoid this. Just as simple it is. Oh. If the king is on the other file, you just give check. When the king is hiding, you attack the pawn.
Then a part of the rule is that the defendant's king has to be in the third line.
Sorry?
The
black king, yeah?
The king has to be in the third line.
Yeah, the king has to be here. I mean, when the fight. He has to be in, like, between these two squares. Sorry, too many squares. Well, I cannot. Too many squares. So I will show you. Yeah, here. Yeah, the king has to oscillate between these two squares. It's very important. To be close, to come back if it's needed, and to attack the rook if it's possible. So we saw it when the king is too far, it's not good. For example, like in this position, in the roi adverse éloigné, here. It's why if your king is here, it will help you a lot, because now your king is going quickly to attack the rook. If you are waiting, for example, if it's white to play, now your king is too far to attack the rook on the third rank. So, yeah, if what you have to understand is this rule is when you defend, your rook need to be in front of the pawn. This is the main thing, never behind, because when it's behind, it's just lost. So in front of the pawn. And your king needs to be like, it's also like on the fifth or sixth rank. It's like, why it's funny, because it's the 5-6 rule, and it's also the 5-6 rule for the king. So it's working for both. Yes. Also, one thing. So, okay. So this we saw. This one, yes, we saw. It's four. What I will show you with. So this rule is working, but with pawn A, there is no rule. I will show you why. With the A pawn. The A pawn is killing everything. So for example, if you have pawn A4, king A3, rook here, king, even king here. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8 should be winning, but with the A pawn there is nothing to do, it's draw. You cannot progress because you cannot go with the king on the, you cannot hide, this is the main problem. So for example, check, 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 and one moment, how we say exactly. I think it's king b4, a5, king f7, and in fact when it's the a pawn there is no way to win the position, because when you go, if you want to go like to progress,
if you can't improve your position pushing your pawn until 7-5, no.
Yeah, the only way to win is to go with the setup.
Is the king in the,
is to go like this.
For example, yeah, and improve one castle more this final. And the first you can win if there are four. For boards in the B8 until the black king, if there are four lines, you can move.
Four lines is winning. Well, four lines is winning. Yeah, it was because you put the rook here. So here you play. For example, you play this. You play. This is four lines, so it's winning. This. This, this, and this.
Yes.
And it's winning. So yeah. So yeah, I put the rook on the bad setup. So it's you need three lines, sorry. So like this. So this is seven and still draw. But I think even I don't want to show you some too complicated position, but even if the king is here, you have this defend lateral check. But okay, this is something else. Just remember with the A pawn is like all the time draw. There is some exception, but it's all the time draw even if you are cut far away. So what is interesting to know is the 5-6 with the B pawn, C pawn. It's mainly with the B pawn and C pawn, because in the game you quite often you reach this position with the B pawn and C pawn, like in my game. As you see here, it was the B pawn. This is the classical position. And also, what is important to know here in this position. When you have black, you want to reach the position when the rook is going here. So it's important to, for example, as we see, if you go behind, you are losing now, because the king will arrive here and you will push. So here you have to protect this square to avoid this push-up before the king is going. Be careful now, he wants to play king c5 and b4, So you have to play rook b4 to attack the pawn. He play rook f3. King g6, king c6. So here you have to be careful also. Black wants, for example, if you play king g5, king c5, rook move b4. Now it's lost. Because even if you give many checks, as possible, you just go king d6, this, and you go king b1. Rook b3, and he will push. So it's important to avoid this and to come back in b8. Because now when he's going, you give the check, and he has to hide. Okay? And this is just a draw. This is winning, but this is the only way to survive later. Okay, so any question about this rule 5-6? If not, I will show you my endgame from yesterday. Do we have the game from yesterday in PGN?
It's going to browser to just before.
Okay. No, but I will put on it. I will. Anyway, it's an end game. So my position from yesterday, it was a long game. It was a good game, but at one point I made a mistake and we arrived in this position. So rook was here, rook on a7, pawn on b, pawn on a2, pawn on b, on g5, king on g1, pawn on h4, h5. King on g8, and I took on b6, yes, like this. Okay, white to move. So, what do you think about this position? Is it a draw or is it a loss?
What color did you play?
I was black. I won, hopefully. It's why rook endgame is very important, because when you know all your rook endgames, even if you play a grandmaster, you can do, you can make a draw easily. So here, rook endgames, there is some few rules, but many rook endgames are draw, even if you are 1 pawn less. So for example, if you have rook and pawn against rook, it's draw if the king is on the same, is not cut. If you have 2 against 1, it's draw. If you have 4 against 3, it's also a draw. Here, one difference, we have this b pawn. So my opponent may play a big mistake here by playing king g2. Here, his main idea is to exchange these 2 pawns. How you can exchange the 2 pawns?
Rook a3 and rook b3.
Yes.
Attack the pawn.
The only trick was a4. a4 is not working because
b4.
a5. No.
Rook b5.
Better.
b3.
And b2. If you play rook b8, you will be on time to go like this. b3. Sorry, rook here, b2, and he will push his pawn, and it will be a draw. Ah, it will be a 4 against 3. 4 against 3, you can play, but it's a draw. So it's why here rook a3 was very good, because for example, I don't know, g6. Rook here, and now it will be easy draw. I have to play rook a6, you take, and we reach this 4 against 3. Not, Not so easy, not so difficult to defend, but it's a draw. Even yesterday, you have this game of Lagarde, French GM, which was 3 against 2 against 2100, and it drew easily. So it's why if you reach even position like this, you have very good chance to draw. So my opponent played King G2. I played before, immediately. I say, at least we didn't exchange these 2 pawns. Of course, it's still a draw. Well, I mean, there is some good chance to make a draw. But I keep this pressure, and you will see. You will see later, it will change the game. He played King F3, I played G6. He played King E4. I played King G7. He played King D4. I played Rook B5. So, the problem for him, if he go like this, now my rook will go like this. And I will try to, I mean, for example, this, I will try to provoke him. If he take, I take. The idea for me is to take even these 2 pawns and maybe to sacrifice on this one. And with my king, I will try to, I will for sure, I will win with my 4 pawns. So, here he play well, he plays something like King E3, King here, he play play some King F3, I play Rook B6, he play King E4, I play Rook D6, ah. We reach this position. King E3, this. No, he played King E2, sorry. Just arrived to the position. And I play F6. Okay, so we have this position. Of course, without the 2 pawn, it's a draw. My idea now is with my king to go like this, close to this pawn. And why not to sacrifice these 2 pawns to manage to take this one and to try to queen. So he played Rook A5, which is a good move to stop my idea of King D5. I play Rook F5, King F5, sorry. And now what is important in Rook endgames, this is the best way to defend this structure, F2, G3, F4. If you are white, if you are black, tac, tac, tac. And if possible, never, 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 ever touch the pawn. Why? Here, he has to play King F3. This is the only way. Not sure it's the draw, but you don't touch the pawn and you stop the king from going somewhere. And you are still in the game. He play F3. Why it's very bad, F3? Because now, this pawn is very weak. And after this move, I immediately play Rook C6. He play Rook B5, I play Rook C3, he play King F2, I play Rook C2, he play King G1, and what do you play with black here?
Rook B2.
Rook B2 or you take the pawn?
No, B2.
Sure?
I think that... No.
You take the pawn or you play Rook B2?
No, Rook E2, after E. E4.
Rook E2? Rook E2, he takes the pawn. So here you have two choices. Or you take the pawn, or you play Rook B2. Who is for Rook B2, who is for Rook
A2? Rook B2, you always can take this pawn.
Yes, not, it's true. You can take it later. It's good. Yeah, as I told you before, the idea is to keep this pawn because with this pawn, you put pressure on this rook, and when this rook is going to give you some check, she will have to have an eye still on this pawn, because you will attack this. So here, Rook B2. And the difference between without the B-pawns, without these 2 pawns, and this and not, it's, now you will see, Rook B2, he play Rook here. No, he play King F1, sorry. I play G5, he take, take. He play Rook here and H4. If you don't have these pawns, No, not rook b4. If you don't have these two pawns, it's a draw. Easy draw, because you will not progress, you will just take on h4, attack the pawn, and give you some checks, and you will not manage to progress with the rook. The king is good. Without these two pawns, the difference is now take. If he give you check, you just move your king. If he attacks the pawns, now you take. And if he takes, b3, rook here, b2, rook e1, b1. So, by keeping these two pawns, it helps me to keep pressure and to change completely the game. What will be interesting if in this position he will have play king f3. I was not sure exactly how to play. I didn't check. I think it should be winning, but it's still not so clear. It depends how I push my pawns. Maybe here I can go like something like e4. If he go king g2, I will try with my king to go like this, even if I have to sacrifice these two pawns, because I have this b pawn so important. And if he go king here, I can maybe try to go h4, and maybe if you go like this, something like this. Not sure if it's winning. I want to say it's not winning, but maybe draw. Or maybe here something very active with king g4. Maybe this is possible. Something like this, check, king, I don't know. King here, and now trying to push with this h pawn, very dangerous, and this g pawn. Like in every endgame, if your king is well placed, it's the most important piece in the endgame. So maybe this is winning. So he made two mistakes in this endgame. What is important to know is if you can completely. The first mistake was king g2. I think it was after tight knot, so he played too fast this move. He has like 40 minutes, so it's why in endgame you need to be very careful. Each move is very important for the rest of the game. And the last move, but he was under pressure of time, it is when he played f3, and this is when you destroy your own structure, because f3, even f3. Rook c6 here. If he come back on the defense, if he come back here, now I can just take and rook g2. It's why when you move, you can have problem. The only tricks here, it's if you take the pawn, you lose the game.
Then if you can achieve weakness in the pawn structure. It's possible to change the pawns of the other side, no?
Sorry?
You say before that if you can achieve a big weakness in pawn structure,
yeah,
in the defense, then you can change pawns without more problems.
Yes. Yeah, no, the best is to have this f2, g3, f4, anyway, all the timing, all the rook endgames, it's the best way, and never touch it. Because in many endgames, often you have this, you start with f2, g3, h4, f2, g3, h2, so h4 is a classical move, because if you don't play, your opponent will play g5, g4, and it's completely different, because now you have these two pawns on f2 and h2 who are completely blocked, and now it's difficult to survive. But h4, it gives you some space and so it's a way to defend with the king on f3. It's very solid. And of course, if there is no pawn here, for example, if you have this position, now this is a draw. This is a draw because Even if you touch your structure, it's a 4 against 3. Even yesterday, the game of Lagarde, it was something like...
It wasn't the pawn H.
Yeah, yeah, there is no pawn H, but it, to show you when you have no pawn on the Lagarde, it was like this. Clear board, it was something like tac, 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 king G6, rook somewhere, rook somewhere, G3, tac, tac, tac. Okay, even this is draw because you don't have pawns on the queen side. If you have a b4 and a2, it's lost because now he will try to do some diversion with the h pawn and come back with the king here. But now this is just a draw because the only trick in I will finish with this about rook endgame. The most difficult one to know it, it's when you have 2 against 1. So when you have this one is very easy to defend. The most difficult one is when you have this one. This one is the most difficult one because you have these two pawns who are quite strong. Your pawn is not in front of these two pawns, so it means that the f5 pawns has quite a good future to provoke or to give you some problems. And here in this position, well, too many words. Ah, yes, I managed. Here in this position, the only way to draw is to keep the rook here, because if you go like this, you will lose very easily because he go rook here, and if you wait, he gives some check, you go like this, and he go f4, and king h4, finito. If you go king g3, same, he go f4, and here he go king h4. Next move, rook b2 and finito. If you go like this, you just go rook b3, finito also. So it means if you have a passive defense, you will lose. How is the only way to make draw here?
Rook a7.
Yeah, rook a7, rook behind the pawn, because if you go like this, now you go king g3. If you go f4, you go like this, okay? And if you go here, you come back in the game. So this is the main one who is difficult. Yeah, there is also this one who is less difficult, but still. No, not save. Still not so easy. With if you inverse pawn and this one. This one is the second one who is quite not so easy. I think there is a game of Polgar who lost, I think, against, I don't remember. But this one is a draw. And what is important to know is to keep the rook on the first rank to avoid the king to go. This is the only rules to know, because in fact when you play h4 there is no way for black to progress because if he moves the rook, you give many check as you can, and if he give h4 you just move your king. Even in g2 it's okay. Rook here, something like even king g1, it's a draw, because what is important is your rook with cutting the king. As we can see, in many endgames, if you can cut the king, it changes completely the game. Even in defense or in attack, in the rule 5-6, you saw it when the king is cut, you need to be very precise with black to make a draw. Okay, so any questions about rook endgames? Or is it good?
But, it's not so easy to draw 4 versus 3.
Four versus three. No. not so difficult when you know it. Okay, it's another another topic to work, but when you know how to defend, normally it's not so difficult.
Okay.
Because if you keep your structure, even if the pawn of the yes.
It's the best option.
Yes. If you have this, because if you have, I mean, if you have this, this will be painful to survive here, because you see your king is completely cut, and somehow he will go g4. And somehow he will go h3, he will try to make some diversion, he will go with the king maybe, and try to win. Because you are completely under pressure. But if you have the good structure with this, already he cannot do something like this. So it means he has to take some, of course if he go h5, I mean if you have something like this, okay, there is check, sorry. For example, if you have a position like this, black cannot go. Okay, for example, king on g2. You have something like this. For black, it's very difficult to progress because when you want to go like this for to do something like e3, or you can attack the pawn, or you can just protect the thing. It's very difficult for him to find a plan. So normally, he will somehow trying to exchange pawns and try to go for f4 at some moment. But even if you go like this, normally he's trying to protect the e-pawn somehow like this, tac, tac, tac. And when he protects, he's trying to play f4
and try to
win this. But even this, it's a draw. But this is a way to do for here. You can make a draw with white with a nice rook e4, rook e4, f3, and pawn endgame. It means even if you reach something fantastic, it's impossible. Well, I mean, it's possible. Many grandmasters lost this position with white, but oftenly when you lose this position, you don't have the good structure. If you have the good structure, I mean, you have a good chance to make a draw. Okay, this is it for Rook and Games. I wish you some very successful Rook and Games during the tournament.